So the best way to solve the problems is through dialogue, trying to find win-win solutions, trying to understand what is the needs and are the needs and interests of the communities, and trying to find a win-win solution to these problems. We started with 20 plus 20 Greek Cypriots and Turkish Cypriots, and we tried to develop a common vision. And our groups, with, from 93 to 97, it went up to 3,000. At that point, and these 3,000 people were not any people. They were NGO leaders, environmentalist leaders, young politicians, teachers. So our leadership in the Turkish Cypriot side said, this is too much. They are growing too much. We have to stop them. So they forbid any crossings to this side. Anyway, all these Turkish Cypriots, most of them were NGO leaders. So when we went back and concentrated on our NGOs, many of us were presidents or in the executive committees in the NGOs. So we decided that we unite the Turkish Cypriot NGOs under a common vision. And we prepared a common vision document. And we visited more than 100 organizations. We had hours of discussions and so on. And at the end of this immense work, most of the NGOs, out of maybe 150, 101 NGOs signed this common vision document. And we started organizing mass demonstrations, starting from 30,000, 50,000, 80,000. And considering that our community's number is 200,000 plus, so it was nearly half of the community was on the streets asking for solution and EU membership. Now, the methodologies you have learned and you will be learning in these workshops is not only for solving problems between the two societies, but within your societies, in mobilizing them towards peace. There are different groups from the society which have clashes of interests. One little example, we had trade unions, a big group, we had business organizations and so on. And we underlined that we should forget about the clashes and class differences, and we should not try to divide a very small cake. We should defend solution and EU membership, which will create a bigger cake to divide within the different parts of the community. So everybody agreed that, okay, forget about the class differences. We join forces for solution and EU membership. To wrap up, I want to say that do not underestimate what you have started doing. The potential, as I say, it can be multiplying. Like if you are 20, that means 20 pairs, maybe 20 times 20, you will have a lot of people. So you can really create an important effect. And once you change your mentalities of trying to understand what are the needs and interests of the others, other community, and try to find and formulate the win-win solutions, then everything becomes much easier to tackle, rather than win-lose solution. So any peace agreement is much better than war and deaths. So I wish you luck, and I congratulate you in taking this, starting this journey.
Well, as my friends as well, I was involved in the bicommunal work for many, many years. And at the first time in 1991, I was invited to a Commonwealth conference where I met for the first time a Greek Cypriot friend after 74, who is the mayor of Nicosia now, Eleni Mavros. We met each other in London, thousands of miles away from our home, where we did not have opportunity to meet on the island. And after this meeting, we also suggested in Commonwealth that there should be meetings also on our island, and the British and the UN and other embassies would help us also to meet here on our island as well. And we invited 25 women from each side, and each of them were present, either residents or high-level members of one NGO. So it was an important group, I can say. And we tried to develop a center similar to the ones in Jerusalem. Of course, in those years, it was very difficult to develop such a center because it was not possible to have it one, because there was no access to each other. And there wasn't enough space on the buffer zone. So we were planning to have it on both sides, two centers. The first thing we did was to change the history books, which were very chauvinistic, and there was a lot of hatred and enemy words towards our neighbors on the island. So we put a lot of cultural elements in it, which expressed our commonalities as well. Of course, we have differences, but we have many, many common sites which was not included in the book. So we put also the cultural history of the Cypriots, and Turkish Cypriots, and Greek Cypriots. So there were a lot of attacks, of course, towards us, but there was a lot of support as well. And we introduced also peace education as pilot projects in some of these schools. Also, we introduced Greek language as the language of the neighbor, because we believe that it is very important to talk in the other language in order to understand each other. One of the obstacles we have is that we have different languages, and we have to talk in a third language. I am very happy to say that although now we have a new government and they begin to change the history books, they couldn't dare to change them to the reverse, to the one it was previously. And they are continuing, for example, the language lessons. So I am hopeful that in the future we shall have a generation who will have the opportunity to talk in their own languages as well.
When we first met, the situation was we were with the United Nations. Who am I and what is he? Mayor? No. Who is he? Me, mayor? No. You are a Greek, you are the mayor of the Greek part of Nicosia, and I am the mayor of the Turkish part of Nicosia, and we don't recognize each other. That was the situation. But of course we knew, both of us, fortunately, he's an architect, I'm a lawyer, but somehow we knew that the town could not go on living in a separated way that it was. One day the city would get united. Why? I don't know, really, I don't know of any city, it were not a state, a city. I don't know of a city which remained always separate. You must have trust.
لازم يكون في ثقة أهم شيء.
And to have trust, you must tell the truth all the time.
ولما يصير في فتوى لازم تحكي الحقيقة طول الوقت.
And if there is something difficult that you cannot agree to.
وإذا في إشي صعب ما بتقدرش توافق معاه عليه.
You take a, you know, a stubborn position and you say no, I cannot do that. It's impossible. You say it's difficult. You're honest with me.
تخش موقف معنّد وصعب إنه تترك.
I don't know whether I shall manage, but I will try.
بعرفش كيف أدبره بس راح أحاول.
The day.
بس بآخر اليوم.
Those who are in authority to take some decision.
اللي في موقع بيقدر يعملوا قرارات لازم يكون عندهم
an understanding.
Any kind of a solution that is going to be materialized on your territories,
أي حل مادي راح يكون في المناطق تاعكم,
will definitely need,
بحتاج على الأكيد,
the commitment of Palestinians and Israelis.
إخلاص الشعب الفلسطيني والإسرائيلي.
In order to have a solution to be survive a solution, there will be definitely a need of committed communities of Palestinians and Israelis.
راح لازم يكون في مجتمعات مخلصة بين الفلسطينيين والإسرائيليين.
And this is the situation as well in Cyprus.
وهذا الوضع في أبرز تفاصيله.
Whatever solution, whatever the name of a solution is going to be,
or the content, راح يكون أو محتوى,
which we hope that it is going to be a federation.
إن شاء الله يكون فدرالي يعني.
We need committed Turkish Cypriots and Greek Cypriots.
بدنا شعب أبرزي تركي أبرزي يوناني مخلص وأبرزي يوناني مخلص.
Having said all these things, is to highlight one thing.
حكيت كل هالشغلات عشان أعمل أحكي في هالشغلة.
To say how important is the dialogue that you have started.
إنه أحكي قديش المهم الحوار اللي أنت بلشت فيه.
And how important is the bicommunal activities that is continuing in Cyprus. So, to finalize, my statement is that under difficult situations, under severe political conflicts,
حتى تحت المشاكل السياسية المعقدة,
it is possible to cooperate.
مش من المستحيل إنه نقدر نتعاون.
When there is mutual need.
لما يكون في احتياجات متبادلة من الطرفين.
If there isn't the mutual need showing itself there.
احتياجات متبادلة.
Out of that need, you cannot derive mutual benefits for your respective communities.
ما بتكاش تعاون مشترك للمجتمع تاعكم.
It may not be possible to cooperate.
بجوز إنه ما يكون من الصعب إنه نتعاون مع بعض.
Having said this, I don't want to stop there because that's not enough. That is the starting point in my view. Out of this experience of so many years, this is the point that I have arrived. That is the starting point, very important point. But it's not enough. You need to have a shared vision for the future of your country, for the future of your city. You need the assistance of the international actors.
لازم تأخذ تعاون من الممثلين الدوليين.
You may need technical, but definitely financial assistance.
لازم طبعا دعم تقني ودعم مصاري.
And this kind of other aspects are also important.
وهذا وكمان هذول أفاق كمان مهمين.
So this is what I wanted to share with you, and I want once again to congratulate you for what you have been doing, and I wish that you are successful.